Welcome to this video of thin layer chromatography for terpenoids.
TLC is a chromatographic technique which is used to separate the components of a mixture using a thin stationary phase. The samples used for this experiment are mint leaves, menthol vaporizer, mint olo, toothpaste, ointment, pudina tablet, and mouthwash. These samples were extracted using ethanol.
Which is the stationary phase used in this separation technique?
The stationary phase used is silica gel 60F254, where 60 indicates the pore size and F254 is the wavelength at which it fluoresces.
And is there any technique for cutting the plate?
Yes, there is a technique for cutting the plate. The plate which we will be using for this experiment is cut in the dimensions of 5 by 10 cm, where 5 cm is the breadth and 10 cm is the length. From the bottom of the plate, mark 1 cm where we will be marking our band length and band space. We will be spotting our sample on the band length. From that spot, mark 8 cm which is your solvent front. Using those dimensions, the plate is cut in this way. Mobile phase used are organic solvents, toluene and ethyl acetate in the ratio 18:2 volume by volume.
But why only these solvents?
As terpenoids are volatile in nature, these two organic solvents are used.
The chamber used is twin trough chamber, which allows low solvent consumption. Next step is chamber saturation. Before pouring the mobile phase into the chamber, we place a filter paper.
Why do we have to place a filter paper in the chamber?
Because the filter paper absorbs the solvent and provides more surface area for evaporation. Thus, the chamber air is thoroughly impregnated with solvent vapor, which keeps the stationary phase from drying out.
How much time does it take for chamber saturation?
It takes 20 minutes. The sample is spotted using a fused capillary on the band length as mentioned earlier. The sample is spotted 5 times in the form of bands on interval of 5 minutes each, allowing the solvent to evaporate in order to get a concentrated band.
How will the separation take place in TLC?
The separation will take place in following manner. It's a vertical development method in which the plate is placed in the chamber such that solvent wets the TLC layer below the starting line. Due to capillary forces, the solvent rises up the layer, transporting the sample mixture based on its polarity and interaction with the stationary phase. Once the solvent reaches the solvent front, the plate is removed and dried. after plate development, why aren't the bands visible?
The bands aren't visible because there are few colorless compounds present in our sample. Hence, we use derivatizing agent. The derivatizing agent used is vanillin sulfuric acid, which is prepared by dissolving 1 gram of vanillin in 90 ml of IPA and 10 ml of H2SO4. Next, out of the two methods, which is dipping and spraying, we will be using the dipping method, following which we will be keeping our plates in the oven at 110 degrees Celsius because the reaction takes place at this temperature.
Is there any other method for derivatization?
Yes, there is a non-destructive method, which is iodine vapors, but we cannot use it since the vapors are toxic.
After visualization, different color bands are observed, indicating presence of different terpenoids, which can be eucalyptol, thymol, eugenol, etc. This is plate 1. First is the standard spotted. Second is the sample, which is mint leaves. Next is plate 2. First is the standard spotted. Next is menthol vaporizer, toothpaste, mouthwash and Mintolo. Next is plate 3. First band is for standard. Next is Pudin Hara and last is for ointment. Similarly, we can perform TLC for other phytoconstituents using suitable standards and solvent system.